long time since I've done a vlog. I've been really busy with work and school and trying to write, so I just wanted to have a quick pop-in and kind of let you guys know what's going on. If you pay attention to my blog at all, on June 7th, I'm actually going to have a big announcement in regards to Celine and the future of the series and where it's going to be as far as availability. And I'm having a hard time actually writing book two. I know Tori recently did a blog post about how really difficult writing a sequel is, and to be completely honest, I'm only about halfway done with chapter 4. I'm going about my goals for these chapters a little differently than I did for book 1. There's not a lot I can tell you about what's going on in book 2 without giving everything away. I can tell you that the way the chapters are, I think that's the best way to term it. The way the chapters are this time around is a lot different than book 1. I've been trying to listen to you guys and implement things that I've heard, you know, people suggest or things like that. There is a big surprise in book 2, but that's pretty on the down low. Or as Dr. River Song says, spoilers. So, I can't tell you too much, but I really hope you guys like it. Going back through book 1 after it was written and everything, I did find a lot of errors, and I know a lot of people are pointing that out. So, it's actually going to be re-released after Jeremy comes out. So it'll be nice and shiny and new. Same cover, same, you know, same everything else, but the inside is going to change as far as editing and things like that. So it's going to be a lot, well, not a lot different, but it's hopefully going to sound a lot better and more professional. What else? Oh, well. For those of you that don't follow me on Facebook, I don't really do Twitter, but if you haven't been following me on Facebook, Trisha Drame, Victoria Barrow, and I are running a group on, a page on Facebook called New Adult Fiction Addiction. And for those of you who don't know what new adult fiction is, new adult fiction is the midway point between young adult and grown-up, just regular fiction. New adult fiction deals with characters roughly between 17 to about 26, depending on the story. But it deals with a lot of the same issues that young adult does, but in a more mature setting. We're able to get away with a lot more with these older characters that we wouldn't have been able to do in young adult or adult. There's still a lot of paranormal, a lot of young love, romance, things like that, but I think that it's a much, much better place to be as far as an author that writes characters that are 20-something, or at least appear 20-something. Because for the longest time, I mean, if you're an author, I'm sure that you know, as far as the whole genre debate, it's been a long road. I mean, you've either got characters that are, you know, too old to be in young adult, but are dealing with, you know, like I said, paranormal, or, you know, how to be 20, things like that. You know, they're dealing with certain situations that might be considered young adults. And then you've got characters that are 17, 18 that are dealing with situations that might be considered adult, or not erotica, but like regular, grown-up fiction. So it's so great to have a midpoint for those characters. We're not in some weird limbo anymore. Anyway, we've got a great lineup coming up. on new adult fiction addiction, also termed NAFA. For those of you who do follow us or haven't been following us, we're calling it NAFA because new adult fiction addiction. But anyway, links are below for everything. We've got a WordPress. Trisha Drame runs the WordPress and does a lot of you know, well, she started the Facebook page. Tori and I are trying to keep up with the authors, keep everything organized. We've got a great lineup, so just check out the blog and check out the Facebook page, and you'll be able to see all of the authors. So far we've had Michelle Prince, the author of Chrysalis. We've had Kellyanne Blount, who did Grishma. We've had Yolanda Allen, who wrote The Wedding Date. And then we've had Scott Pressing. We've had a lot of really great authors so far, and I mean, we're booked through the beginning of August, so it's crazy to see that authors are really, really taking to this, and it's really kind of humbling that people are like, we want to be on your page, and it's like, oh my god. But that's enough rambling for that. I'm trying to think of what else I can tell you guys. Really, other than that, I mean, there's not a lot going on. Thank you guys for all of your love and support, and if you have any questions, you can always, of course, email me. My author email is pretty much well known at this point, I think. But I do have one thing before I let you guys go. If you buy a paperback copy of Celine and take a picture of yourself with it and post it on the Night Touch Facebook page, the first 10 people who do that will win a free digital copy of Jeremy, and the first person to do it will win a free signed paperback copy of Jeremy. So that's really exciting, and I mean, you know, what's not to love? I know everybody's in the digital age, I mean, I'm guilty of it, but I definitely, definitely think that you guys should have a paperback copy of this book, because it is, it's pretty. It's really pretty. That's my favorite part about it. It's so pretty. But anyway, so definitely, if you get a paperback copy of Celine, take a picture of yourself with it. You don't even have to like be like selfie. You don't have to be like, oh, it's the book. You can, if you take a picture of the book, and maybe in your lap or next to, you know, something with your name on it, you'll get a free digital copy of Jeremy. And like I said, the first person to do this will win a free signed paperback copy of Jeremy when it comes out. So thank you guys for all of your love and support. I greatly appreciate it, and see you guys soon.